Here, I'm going to show you everything you need to use AI to make macros in Excel. And you do not have to learn any programming or any VBA at all. This tutorial is for everyone. And there's three parts to this tutorial. First, I'm going to show you how to actually create the macro and then run it in Excel, so the full process. Then I'm going to show you how to craft your own prompt to create your own macro to do whatever you need it to do. Then I'm going to show you how to troubleshoot any errors. I'm going to use ChatGPT, but this will also work with Copilot or one of the many, many other AIs that are out there now. And even though you don't have to learn VBA, we do have a full course that will teach you how to completely automate Excel, and you can get the link to it below this video. It's probably on sale, and it covers pretty much everything you need to know. But now let's get into this tutorial. First up, let me show you what the macro is going to do. It's going to take this ugly, unformatted data that we have pasted into Excel and turn it into this usable data with the click of a button. Let's run it, Alt F8. We have a few macros open. Click the name of the macro that we care about. I'll show you how to figure that out as we install the macro. Hit run. And I made the macro that did this with a simple text prompt to AI. Now, the first step to creating your macro is to get your prompt. Here we have a prompt, and I am going to go over all three of the sections for this prompt so you can make your own. This is going to be the most important part of the tutorial when I go through this. But right now, let me show you how easy it is once you have this completed. I'm going to select it, copy it. Go to my favorite AI, in this case, ChatGPT. We're going to use 4.0. And in a moment, we will also use O3 Mini High, an amazing model, actually. Choose your model, paste your prompt, enter. Wait a moment while it writes it. I'll fast forward through it. And you get your macro. In a nice, neat little window where we can just click the copy button right here and move on to the next step. Now, it may look like this, or it may look a little bit different in a feature called Canvas. That's for ChatGPT. In Copilot, it's just going to be a little window that's not very user-friendly, but there's many different AIs, so don't get hung up on the interface too much. This is the macro. We want to copy it and then paste it in. I'm going to go over here. ChatGPT O3 Mini High. This is a great model, works a little bit different. I'm not going to cover it too much here, but I'll at least show you what it did. It explained all of its steps, all of the logic and the reasoning, and there's quite a lot of it. This can be quite interesting or helpful. And down here, finally, we have the macro itself. And you'll notice it looks a bit different than the 4.0 model. And that's how AI works. That's also why it can be really useful to use the most advanced model. Let's use this one. I'm going to go ahead and copy it. Go back to Excel, hit Alt F11. This is the VBA window where we will install the macro. If you have multiple workbooks open like I do, make sure that you have selected the correct one right here. If you can't see this window, go to View and click Project Explorer. Then click your workbook, go to Insert, Module, paste in the macro, scroll to the top, and note the name of the macro. You can attach this to a button, so you can click the button and run the macro, or like we are going to do, run it by hand. You can click in here and hit F5 or the green button to run it, but it can be a little bit nicer to run it from the worksheet itself. Now I am going to rename this to OO, so we don't conflict with the existing macro that I have already copy-pasted in here for this tutorial. Then we can hit Alt F11 or this green button right here. Go back to Excel. Now hit Alt F8. And we can see all the macros that we can run. And sales analysis macro is right here. The one that we just copy pasted in and the renamed one OO, so we did not have a conflict. Click the macro, hit run, and it runs your macro just like we did at the beginning of the tutorial. So those are the steps to create the macro. Once you understand how to do that, right? You've got your account for AI, you've got your prompt, you've got everything set up. It'll take less than a minute to do all of that. If you want to attach it to a button, I'll show you how to do that real quick. Make yourself a nice little button. Insert, illustrations, shapes, rounded rectangle, draw a button, button, go to the home tab, And let's center that bad boy. Maybe bold. Right click. It's off the screen, but go to Assign Macro. This window pops up again. Sales Analysis Macro. Hit OK. Click away. Now, if I click the button, it's going to run the macro again. That's not what we want for this example, but I wanted to make sure you knew how to attach it to a button, because this tutorial is geared for people who are not experts in VBA and macros. Now I'm going to go ahead and right click this and cut this. Very easy way to get the button out of here. And now that you know how to do that, the full process, let's go to maybe the most important part of this tutorial, the prompt. There are three important sections here. This one right here, this one right here, and this one down here. These are going to serve as the foundation of all of your prompts. And it will make it very easy to not only create the macro, but then add new features to the macro, change it, and troubleshoot it, which I'm going to show you at the end, because oftentimes AI will generate errors. That's one more thing I have to mention. Please do not run a macro on your workbook until you have backed up that workbook. Now, the three sections are the role. You're going to tell it what it is. You're going to give it some instructions, some general instructions, not always specific to just this single task at hand or this single macro. And then down here, very specifically, a to-do list of everything it should create a macro to do. Now, you can add additional sections, but these are the three most important. So let me go through them now, and I'll give you some tips for writing them as well. Up here, you're going to tell AI what it is, because right now it doesn't know what it is. It's got all this information. You need to tell it what it's going to specialize in. You are an Excel VBA master. You will create a macro for Excel using VBA. Maybe you want to make that more extensive. You are an expert in statistics. You're an expert in sales. You are an expert in The Office TV show. Whatever you need, you put that up here. Make it as big as it needs to be. And you can even give it a little title as well. Once you have the role established, it's time for the instructions. Now, instructions are not always needed, but they can be helpful. In this case, they were very helpful. First off, I wanted to make sure that AI told me what was going on. So for number one, I said, comment the code and explain what it does. And then I also said, for each action, put it in its own section. That's going to help break it up and comment it, so it's easier for me to look at it and read it and figure out what's going on. If you know a little bit of VBA, that's really going to help you. Next up was something very specific. For each search that you perform, make sure to go through the entire worksheet and use the find method for a search. Now, that was going to be a little bit harder for you to figure out. Going to be through trial and error. You ask it to do something for you, it kind of gets it wrong. Then you have to go and you have to update your instructions. And I'll tell you how to figure out which instruction and which line item down here to work on towards the end of this tutorial when I give you an example of an error. Number three is a personal favorite of mine, not at all required. I don't want AI to explain a bunch of stuff to me. I already understand how VBA works, so just give me the code, please. Thank you very much. O3 goes through its logic, but it still at least only gives you the macro code at the end. And then double check your code to ensure that it works without error. A very, very good instruction. Sometimes not needed, sometimes very much needed. You can make your instructions as long as you need to make them. When I do this in a professional capacity for AI, some of the instruction sections are well over 1,000 words, and that is not at all seen as excessive. Now, it depends on the AI that you're using. Sometimes they'll have a character limit. But if you get a more professional version of AI, you can make this really big. It's going to help you out a lot. So put everything that you want it to note and every way that you want it to work. If there are multiple ways to do something in Excel and VBA, there are always many ways to do the same thing. You can put that here. You want it to favor one worksheet function over another worksheet function. You could put that here. Those kinds of things. Next up, step by step. The most important thing for this third section is break it up into tiny little pieces. Pretend like you are talking to a first year intern who does not want to be there, but is forced to perform a task. How much should you break it down? This much. Work on the currently visible worksheet. Remove all formatting, remove all links, remove all objects. Could you put all three or four of those in one line in one item? Yes, you could. But the more things you group together, the higher the chance for an error. So be as explicit as possible. And break it up so that it is very easy for you to read and understand. The easier it is for you to read and understand, the easier it is for the AI to do so. That's also why we use numbered bullet points here. And it can be helpful to put the things that you want it to do first at the top of the list. In Excel, sometimes that is very important. You cannot perform an action on a table until you have turned the data into a table, that kind of thing. And when referencing text or string literals, so things that are actually inside of a cell, make sure to put quotation marks around it. Do not assume that it's going to understand that a cell will have a plus sign, a space, and then the word options after it. Use quotation marks. Very important. We also use it here for column headers and also the name of the table. And do not let Word correct spelling for you. Another really helpful tip here is, let's say that we wanted to do something down here with cell A2. Cell A2 should have the text next up in it. Well, you shouldn't really word the phrase that way. So that's the first step. Should have. Okay. Well, remember, it's your first year intern. What do you mean should have? Do I need to put it in cell A2 or not? Yes. So we could reword it like this. Put sales analysis in cell A1. So we would say, put the text next up in cell A2. For this worksheet, when we are cleaning data and it's to be used in a new workbook, this can work just fine. However, when you are going to reference cells where you want to get a value from them, so let's say, get the input value from cell B2 and store it on worksheet data in cell B2. Now that can cause some problems. Why? Well, we only mentioned the name of one worksheet here. But up here, we did say that we're going to be working on the currently visible worksheet. So maybe it'll be okay. It kind of depends on the AI. But to make your life so much easier, we want to name the cells. Get the input value from cell. Let's just delete this. The cell named input value. And put that value into the cell named output value. Naming cells will make your life so much easier. So name them, make sure you surround the quotes with names inside of your prompt. If you don't know how to name a cell, I will show you right now. Click the cell right here, go up here, new name, enter. Now you have a named cell called new name. We can click it. Let's click away. Click it, and it goes to that cell. Once you've got those tips down, you are on your way to making amazing macros using AI. But sometimes you get errors. So let me show you how to troubleshoot an error. We have an unformatted worksheet, Alt F8. Let's go to Clean and Format Sales Data 1. I have a feeling that one will cause an error. There we go. Error 1004. Application denied or object defined error. Don't you love that? Doesn't really help you that much, does it? But click debug. And we now have a yellow line. What can we do with that yellow line? Well, let me show you an amazing debug prompt. And here it is. There's an error in the following line. Code that Excel highlighted in yellow is causing the error. Perfect, we've got that. Which step of my instructions caused this piece of code to be in the macro? I need to know this so that I can remove or update that step. click the line that's highlighted in yellow, Shift End to select the entire line, Control C to copy that line. Go in here, paste it in, copy it. It's very helpful to get your prompt sorted in Microsoft Word before you go to AI, especially if you want to save them for later and update them and change them. Under where it just gave you that macro, paste your new prompt, enter. It'll give you a long explanation of what happened, but this is the most important part. Step 7. Remove any empty rows that appear above the cell that contains the value sale ID. Now we can go back to our prompt, locate the problem step, and start troubleshooting. If you know VBA and macros, you can go directly to the macro and probably pretty quickly change it and fix it yourself. You will still save a lot of time because it already made the macro for you. All you have to do is make a few tweaks here and there. But if you don't know how to use VBA and macros, this at least identifies where it is in your instruction set that caused the issue. Now we can look at number 7 and do one of a few things. Think, okay, do we need to remove the empty rows that appear above that cell? Actually, I don't need to. So I could just remove step 7. Now I could rerun it and retest it. In this case, it actually did fix the macro when I did that. Now the model that I used that created the error was not the O3 model. So that's why if you're using ChatGPT, I do recommend that you use that model for code generation at least. But maybe you really need this step to be in here. So what you need to do at that point is to figure out how to reword this to make it easier for AI to understand and then harder for it to mess up when creating the macro. Maybe what you could do is to take step 7 and put it all the way at the end. Maybe you reword it to say leave only one empty row above sale ID. There are many things that you can do, and there's no one right answer. You're just going to have to troubleshoot it and play around with it, change the wording, change the order in here, until you're able to get it to generate the correct output. In this case, the easiest thing to do would be to use the O3 Mini High ChatGPT model, the one that leaves beautiful, amazing comments. Look at these great comments. So easy to read, and it worked perfectly the first time that I ran it. So that would be the easiest thing to do here. But it's still very important to understand how to locate where the error occurred so you can troubleshoot it. At this point, you should have a very strong foundation that's going to allow you to create your own prompt and then go to AI, whichever model you choose to use, and create a fairly good working macro to automate your workflow within Excel. Don't forget, if you'd like to learn VBA and macros so you can create your own macros or more easily troubleshoot the macros created by AI, we have a full course on that that'll take you from beginner all the way to expert in this single course. It's on teachexcel.com, and I'll put a link to it below this video. And it's probably on sale, so give it a look. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you can get all of our future tutorials. And if you know a friend who might like it, please share it with them. Have a great one, and I'll see you soon.